Namaste, myself Mr. Birajdar Balasaheb, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video lecture, we will discuss application of first order and first degree ordinary differential equation, part 2. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to find orthogonal trajectories of the family of Cartesian curve. Already we discussed in video 1 regarding working rule to find orthogonal trajectory of Cartesian curve. In this video session, we will illustrate more examples on orthogonal trajectory of family of Cartesian curve. Let us pause the video for a while and write answer to the given question. Question is, form a differential equation of the family of curve x into y equal to c, where c is a parameter. Come back. I hope you have written answer to this question. Here, I will going to explain the solution of this question. Given curve is x into y equal to c, denoted by equation 1. Now we have to form its a differential equation. For that, we have to differentiate this curve with respect to x, so that the derivative of left hand side by using product rule, as x keeping as it is and derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx plus y as it is and derivative of x with respect to x is 1 is equal to derivative of constant c is 0. This is equation 2. Now this is a differential equation of given curve x into y equal to c. Now let us consider the example. Example 1. Find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curve y square equal to c in bracket 1 plus x square, where c is parameter. Solution. Let us denote the given curve y square equal to c in bracket 1 plus x square by equation 1. Now differentiate both the side with respect to x. We get derivative of y square is 2y into dy by dx is equal to c as it is, and in bracket derivative of 1 is 0 plus derivative of x square is 2x. Now cancel 2 from both the side. We get y into dy by dx is equal to c into x. Denote this equation by 2. Now we have to eliminate parameter c between equation 1 and 2. For that, from equation number 1, we can find value of c as y square upon 1 plus x square. Now substitute this value of c in right side of equation 2, we get y into dy by dx is equal to x into y square upon 1 plus x square. Now 1y gets cancelled from both the side, which gives dy by dx equal to x into y upon 1 plus x square. Denote this equation by 3. This is the differential equation of given Cartesian curve. In order to find orthogonal trajectory, we have to replace dy by dx by minus dx upon dy in this equation 3. We get minus dx upon dy equal to x into y upon 1 plus x square. Denote this equation by 4. This is the differential equation of orthogonal trajectory. Now we have to solve this equation number 4 using any one of the suitable method of solution of first order and first degree differential equation. Here method of separating the variable is applicable, so that we can separate the variable as 1 plus x square upon x into dx is equal to minus y into dy. In the left hand side, we can simplify as 1 upon x plus x square upon x gives x, and bracket close into dx is equal to minus y into dy. This is called as variable separable form. Now on integrating both this side, integration of 1 by x plus x into dx is equal to integration of minus y into dy, which implies in the left hand side we can separate the integration for each term. We get integration of 1 by x into dx plus integration of x into dx equal to minus integration of y into dy. Therefore, integration of 1 by x with respect to x is log x plus integration of x with respect to x is x square by 2 is equal to minus sign as it is, and integration of y with respect to y is y square by 2 plus k constant of integration. Therefore, x square by 2 plus log x, and when we bring minus y square by 2 to left side, it becomes plus y square by 2 is equal to constant k. Now multiply by 2 on both these side, we get x square plus y square plus 2 into log x equal to 2 into constant k. This is the family of a curve which is orthogonal to given family of a curve. Let us consider another example, example 2. Find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curve y equal to x plus a into e raised to x. Now solution. Let us denote the given curve y equal to x plus a into e raised to x by equation 1. Again differentiate both the side with respect to x. We get dy by dx equal to derivative of x is 1 plus a constant as it is, and derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Denote this equation by 2. Now we have to eliminate parameter a between 1 and 2. For that, from equation 1, we can write value of a into e raised to x as y minus x and substitute this value in the right hand side of equation 2. We get dy by dx is equal to 1 as it is plus value of a into e raised to x is y minus x. This equation is denoted by 3. This is the differential equation of given Cartesian curve. Now to find orthogonal trajectory in equation number 3, we have to replace dy by dx by minus dx upon dy. We get minus dx upon dy is equal to 1 plus y minus x. Now multiply minus sign on both the side, which gives dx upon dy is equal to x minus y minus 1. Denote this equation by 4. This is the differential equation of orthogonal trajectory. Now we have to solve this equation number 4. Here the method of separation of variable is not applicable, but equation 4 we can write as dx upon dy minus x equal to minus in bracket y plus 1. This is the linear differential equation of first order and first degree with x as a dependent variable, that is of the type dx upon dy plus p dash x is equal to q dash, where p dash and q dash are functions of y. But after comparison, here the value of p dash is minus 1 and value of q dash is minus of y plus 1. Now, in order to find the solution of this differential equation, first of all, we find it's a integrating factor. By formula, integrating factor equal to e to power integration of p dash with respect to y. But here p dash is minus 1, so that it is equal to e raised to integration of minus 1 into dy, which is equal to e raised to minus y. Therefore, integrating factor is equal to e raised to minus y. Now, general solution of this differential equation is x into integrating factor is equal to integration of integrating factor into value of q dash into dy plus constant k. Now, substitute the value of integrating factor and q dash in this equation. We get x into e raised to minus y is equal to integration of e raised to minus y in bracket minus of y plus 1 bracket close into dy plus k. Therefore, x into e raised to minus y is equal to, now minus sign you can take outside the integration, and into integration of e raised to minus y in bracket y plus 1 into dy plus constant k. Now we have to integrate right hand side integration using integration by parts. Here y plus 1 created as a first function denoted by u, and e raised to minus y is a second function denoted by v. Therefore, x into e raised to minus y is equal to minus in bracket, keeping y plus 1 as it is, and into integration of e raised to minus y is minus e raised to minus y minus integration. Derivative of y plus 1 with respect to y is 1, and into integration of e raised to minus y is minus e raised to minus y into dy bracket close plus constant k. Therefore, x into e raised to minus y equal to minus in bracket minus of y plus 1 into e raised to minus y. Then minus sign you can take outside, becomes plus into integration of e raised to minus y is again minus e raised to minus y bracket close plus constant. Therefore, x into e raised to minus y equal to, when we multiply this minus sign inside, we get y plus 1 into e raised to minus y, then minus minus plus e raised to minus y plus constant k. Therefore, x into e raised to minus y equal to, in the right hand side, in the first two term, when we take e raised to minus y is common outside, in bracket we get y plus 1 plus 1, that gives y plus 2, and into e raised to minus y plus constant k. This is the required equation of family of a curve, which is orthogonal to given family of a curve. To prepare this video lecture, I use this book as a references. Thank you.